From DocuSign, this is Developing with DocuSign. This video is the second part of a multi-part instructional series on how to deploy a DocuSign Connect Center on Google Cloud Platform. My name is Nima Pollad, a developer advocate with DocuSign. In the previous video, we talked in detail about what is DocuSign Connect and the security risks involved with opening a hole in your firewall to receive the Connect notifications. We also covered how using the serverless architecture is more secure and will prevent you from opening a hole in your firewall altogether. I have a link to the previous video in the description below. Please refer to it as a refresher. In this video, I'll walk you through how you can set up the listener using Google Cloud Platform. The first thing that you want to do is to go ahead and navigate to our Git repository and clone the repo. I have a link to the repo in the description below. Next up, you want to make sure that you have the serverless framework installed on your local machine. Please refer to the previous video for installation instructions. The next step is to create the credentials for your serverless accounts. Serverless has really good documentation on how to do this, and I've left a link to this page in the description below. Please follow the instructions and create your keyfile.json that contains your credentials. Throughout the demo, I will be storing my keyfile in the same path as what you see here, which is .cloud/keyfile.json. But please go ahead and update that path to wherever you end up storing your key file. Next up, let's go ahead and define a few environment variables that we're going to need. First, let's define location. This is where we want our resources to be deployed. In this case, I'm using US Central 1. Next up, we need to define our Google project ID. You can obtain this value from your Google dashboard. Next up, we need to pick a queue name that we're going to use. This is where the Connect notifications are going to be stored, and this is the name of the pop-up resource that serverless is going to be creating for us. We're also going to need the authentication name and authentication password. The authentication name can be contained from your Connect configuration inside your DocuSign dashboard. The same is true for the password. You can also contain this information from your Connect configuration. And last but not least, you also need to define the HMAC that we'll be using to verify the Connect messages. Now that you have your environmental variables defined, now we can go ahead and deploy the GCP function in our subscription. Go ahead and type SLS deploy. Please keep in mind that this process is going to take a while, as serverless is going to deploy your GCP function, and it will also create the pop-up resource that we're going to need to queue the notifications inside of it. While the deployment is ongoing, let's go ahead and look at our serverless.yaml file and understand the different parts of this configuration. First of all, you're gonna see that we define our provider to be the Google Cloud Platform. And this is where I specified my credentials. This is the credentials that you obtain after creating your service account using Google's dashboard. Under the functions tag, this is where we define the functions that we want to deploy. In our case, we only have one function and it's called the Connect. And it also comes with a bunch of environmental variables that it is going to need to verify the authenticity of Connect and the notifications that are coming in. In the last tag, this is where we create any extra resources that we need. In our case, we're going to need a pop-up topic so we can enqueue the Connect messages on top of it. And we're also going to have to define a subscription as well. Without the subscriptions, we're not going to be able to pull any messages off the topic and view them. At the very least, we have a tag for defining the dependencies between the topic and a subscription. The depends on tag essentially specifies that we want the topic to be created first before we create a subscription. When the deployment is finished, you're going to see the endpoint to your function listed in the output. The very last step is to go ahead and update your Connect configuration with this new URL that we just obtained from deploying our Google function. So let's go ahead and put our URL inside the configuration and let's save our Connect configuration. Now let's go ahead and test our Google function. I have invoked a couple of Connect notifications, and as you can see, the new message has come in. We verified that the HMAC is valid and when we enqueue the message inside our PubSub resource. So as you can see, the function is being invoked on the messages that come in. And that's it. Thank you so much for joining us today. And please be sure to subscribe to our channel so you won't miss any future videos.